The more we have been here, the more we have come to like and appreciate the central area, and actually many of your streets. In lots of areas, you're doing many good things. Rotterdam, my sense of it is, as a city of great energy and strength. We're going to talk about streets and why they are so important. We'll make some general observations. We'll make some challenges. We'll give some challenges. We'll talk about our working method, or Elizabeth will. And we're going to talk about the characteristics of the best streets and weave Rotterdam streets within those qualities. As we talk during, this is a single lecture, but I'll open it up. Elizabeth will then talk for a while, then I'll talk again, and Elizabeth will close it. Let's talk first about why streets are important. Streets are known by their patterns and the recognizable physical forms that they create. And I bet you know most of these. There is Paris in the upper left at the Étoile. That's a square mile, or 1.6 kilometers on a side. And all of these that I'm going to show you are at the same scale. So that one is at the same scale as this. That's very little of Paris, you notice. It almost looks like somebody threw a pebble at a glass and it shattered. And that's the pattern you get out of the Étoile. Rome is next on the upper right. By the way, Rome, I do crazy things like counting. So there are 504 intersections in that square mile of Rome. If you know Rome, that covers an awful lot of central Rome. An intersection is where you have a choice to go one way or another. So that's an intersection, that's an intersection, that's not an intersection. You can't choose. You have choices, 504 choices. Choice is not unimportant of where you go. Paris has 281. San Francisco, my city, has little over 300 intersections. There's the main street, Market Street, and it ends at the Ferry Building. And when I did this map, there was a freeway here, too. You know, it ended. We had a revolution against freeways in the 60s, and that was the end of freeways. They stood there for a long time, unfinished. But that's the main street. None of this is here. That spaghetti is no longer there. That's the main street. The biggest, that's the widest street in the city. And then comes Brasilia. Brasilia has about 63 intersections. And if you know Brasilia, you know you don't walk in Brasilia. You drive. That's how you get around. From place to place you drive. That's a driving city. By the way, just for kicks, if I showed you the map of Venice, 1.6 kilometers by 1.6 kilometers gets almost all of Venice. And it gets over 1,700 intersections. I've never counted any more. And it gets to be so many where you don't know where you are, but you somehow never get lost. Or you love it when you are. Let's go on. So we'll put the central area 1.6 by 1.6 kilometers of Rotterdam next to San Francisco. That's interesting. There are fewer intersections here in that space than there are in San Francisco. And notice how wide some of the streets are. And there's a grid here. And there are a lot of street, a lot of cities like that. And one understands the difficulty of getting through, and if it's an automobile-oriented city, it's going to come to trouble at some point without great transit and arranging housing so that you don't have to go all over the place to get where you're going. Just to keep going, that's Portland, Oregon, probably as walkable a city as we have in our country. Small blocks. So that goes all over. It's not just downtown. This is downtown. Each of those blocks is a little over 60 meters by about 60 meters. That's what they are. Very, very walkable city. And the traffic just, you know, it just filters everywhere. It's fascinating how it works. It's a very, very livable city. The form of Atlanta, Georgia, an old, old American city. Governor Oglethorpe designed it.
Savannah.
Excuse me, Savannah. What did I say?
Atlanta.
Ooh, shame on me. Of Savannah, Georgia. What's interesting about that, one of the interesting, every one of these is a park. And they were designed that way to be the centers of neighborhoods. That's old, it's old stuff. And it's the kind of place where once you see the pattern, you know it, or think you know it, and even think you can draw it, and you do draw it, and you draw it wrong, but it doesn't matter. That's Savannah. And then we're back to Rotterdam. Big streets, big blocks, but then small streets. Let me talk about the importance of streets. As Ari suggested, we tend to take them for granted. But they're more than traffic carriers, more than access to property, more than places for utilities, more than access for public safety vehicles. In large measures, streets constitute the public realm. They're places to walk. They're places to see and meet people. Neighbors and strangers alike. their socializing places, as here in Copenhagen, their political places. You know this place. I don't know it like this. At the fountain at the end of Cool, or beginning of Cool Single. They're political places where people have the ability to demonstrate, to express joy, to parade or celebrate, or to express anger. Think not so many years ago in East Europe, Eastern European countries, where the demonstrations took place. They took place in the streets. Try having a demonstration on the mall, on a mall. Try it. You get thrown off, won't you? It's private. The mall takes away the freedom. It's too easy. If, as in Portland, you have a lot of trees and sunlight and greenery, then they become ecological places. They become environmentally responsible places, places for air and sunlight. They're places for kids to play, to be, and play and be taken. It's too easy to forget that streets are for more than cars and for more than parking. And I return to that statistic. They take up between 25 and 35% of urban developed land. That's huge. That is more often than not in most cities, maybe not here, the single largest use of land. And they are owned by the public. They are the public's. And the public controls them. And the public can design them. Design them well, and you will largely have designed the city well. Elizabeth will talk about how we go about looking and matters such as that.